Hey guys, Jay, Great Scott Audio Productions, and Bitten by Books, Book Bites. Happy New Year, happy holidays, and all the other refinements. Today we're going to do Nightlife by Rob Thurman. A lot of fun. Nifty series, a lot of fun. Can't really go wrong with it. Monsters, bad guys, good guys, all the best things in life. We're going to go ahead and jump right into chapter one, and we'll see what we see. Most kids don't believe in fairy tales for very long. Once they hit six or seven, they put away Cinderella and her shoe fetish, Three Little Pigs with their violation of building codes, Miss Muffet and her well-shaped tuffet, all forgotten or discounted. And maybe that's the way it has to be. To survive in the world, you have to give up the fantasies, the make-believe. The only trouble is that it's not all make-believe. Some parts of the fairy tales are all too real, all too true. There might not be a Red Riding Hood, but there is a big bad wolf. No Snow White, but definitely an evil queen. No obnoxiously cute blonde tots, but a child-eating witch, yeah. Oh yeah. There are monsters among us. There always have been, and there always will be. I've known that ever since I can remember, just like I've always known I was one. Well, half of one anyway. And regardless of what inherited nastiness I might have on the inside, on the outside I was all human. In fact, Nico had said, and pretty damn frequently, that I had more human qualities than I had good sense. He never hesitated to remind me that no matter how god-awful I thought my problems were, I was still his punk-ass kid brother. And I wanted to beat up on myself, I'd have to go through him first. Nico was such a Boy Scout, albeit one with a lethal turn and a merit badge in deadly weapons. Nico, for all his fascination with sharp, pointy things, didn't have a drop of monster blood in him. Of course, his father could barely be classified as human in my book, but technically the man met the definition. Worthless bastard. Nico had never met him. Not really. He'd been 2 weeks old when his dear old dad had taken off. I wasn't sure that counted as meeting. There were some true parenting skills at work. 2 weeks and gone. Hell, I'd seen my father more than that. Yeah, I'd seen mine at least once a month. It watched me. There were no father and son chats, no invites to see the monster cousins, no interaction of any sort. There was just a shadowed figure lurking in an alley as I passed. Or maybe a silhouette with lithe, sinuous lines and sharp, sharp teeth cast against my window at night. Of course, it wasn't like it was wearing a name tag that said Dad on it or leaving me birthday presents topped with a bow tied by unnaturally long clawed fingers. I had no proof it was my demonic sperm donor, but come on. When your mother is quick to tell you you're a freak and an abomination that should have been aborted on cheap bathroom tile, you have to think, why else would this monster be stalking me? Funny. That monster had more interest in me than my mother ever had. Over the years, I got used to it, the shadowing. A couple of times, I tried to approach it out of curiosity or a morbid death wish. Who knew? But it always disappeared, melting into the darkness. Mostly, I was relieved. It was one thing to be part monster, another thing to embrace that less-than-Mayflower heritage. Then, when I was 14, that all changed. After that, I didn't look for monsters. I ran from them. Actually, we ran from them, Nico and I. For 4 years, that felt more like 40, we ran. Ran until it was a way of life. It wasn't the kind of life Nico deserved, but... Didn't he listen to me when I told him so? Shit, hardly. My brother had made a career out of trying to protect me. Talk about your minimum wage, no benefits, occupations. Thanks, guys. Next time we are going to visit with Terry Brooks,
Yes, I know. It's a big-time author. He's a wonderful, wonderful man. Lives here in the Pacific Northwest. This book, The Elf Stones of Shannara, is going to become an MTV movie, or excuse me, TV series, which geekness heaven for so many people, myself, friends of mine that we've been reading these since we were children. My first purchased with my own money book was the first book, The Sword of Shannara, and I bought that in 1977 when it had just come out. Read the thing to pieces, bought it again in 1982. That's the copy I got signed by Terry when he was here. This one as well, bought in 1982 at the same time, and it's actually still in fairly good shape. So we're gonna go ahead and read that next time in homage to the creation, finally, of the vision of the Elf Stones. Not only that, for Terry's birthday, which was just, I believe, yesterday or the day before, so happy birthday, Terry. Thank you again so much. Have a good week. Take care.